established rules ng committee, Madam Chair?
Siguro first observation, no, yung on the budget for the 2024, yung Vice President na nagsabi, Madam Chair, na slow and low utilization. So nakita naman natin doon sa presentation. So yung utilization ay napakababa. Pero syempre comment ko lang, no, mas mabilis siya sa confidential funds. 100% in 11 days.
Madam Chair.
So, Madam Chair, so according to the utilization of the confidential and intelligence funds submitted by the COA to us, no, so we can we have here surveillance and monitoring. Sabihin ko lang, Madam Chair, no, yung purchase of information out of 125 million confidential funds in 2022, purchase of information 14 million, payment of reward 10 million, rental and other incidental expenses relative to the maintenance of safe houses 16 million, purchase of supplies 35 million, provision of medical and food aid 40 million, payment of incentives or traveling relative to confidential operations 10 million. So a total of 125 million conducted surveillance in 132 areas in 11 days.
Yes, Madam Chair.
So
may I remind both our guests and our resource
persons. You should have reminded her when she said the line, diba? I called your attention, Madam Chair. You did not recognize me. So, ngayon, sasabihin ko na, if you allowed her that, you allowed me a snide comment as well.
I don't recall hearing a snide comment, Madam Vice President. Ang snide comment, that's okay. A matter of judgment. So, please proceed
Secretariat,
with your...
Madam Chair, I would like the Secretariat to repeat the first three lines of... the comments.
Well, point of order, Madam Chair. Point of order, Madam Chair. Kasi parang...
So let's please proceed with the answer. Yeah.
Point of order, Madam Chair. Kasi parang siya yung nagpe-preside eh.
Yes, may ganun talaga ang buhay, ma'am.
Kasi inuutusan mo yung secretariat natin sa Committee on Appropriation.
Yes. Madam Vice President, please proceed with the response. There's a question. Please proceed with the response.
Madam Chair, I do not understand bakit a person convicted of child abuse is still sitting in a seat
point of order,
the House
Madam
of
Chair,
Representatives.
Ito yung sinasabi natin na dinadivert ang gaang-usapan sa ating budget hearing. Kung nagawa po niya yan sa Senado, Madam Chair, dapat hindi natin yan pahintulutan dito sa Kamara.
You allowed her a snide comment and then you will not allow
Please.
Me?
Please wait
as
to be recognized.
Comment.
Excuse me, our members and our guests.
I warn
you. Please wait
don't
to be
into this rabbit hole.
Please wait to be acknowledged before you speak. Okay, so at this point, Honorable Manuel.
Yes, Madam Chair, again, it's another point of order kasi kapag may mga deliberasyon tayo, we should stick to the topic. Hindi pwede, Madam Chair, na dinadivert natin yung usapan para hindi natin sagutin yung tanong ng mga mambabatas natin. This is actually the best opportunity, formal proceedings, nakikita po ng publiko, para malaman anong sagot ng Vice Presidente. So hindi po natin napapayagan ang ganong mga argumento na hindi naman tumutumbok dun sa topic natin.
This is a hearing of the budget of 2025. Nasaan dito ang confidential funds? Yung tanong niya,
Madam
confidential
Chair,
funds. Nasaan dito?
Honorable
Madam
Friends,
Chair,
you may
ito
proceed.
Yung continuing, ano ko pa to, no? Continuing questions pa natin noong 2024. During the last budgets, hindi na ipaliwanag itong 125 million na alam naman natin na wala ito sa budget ng 2022. So, eto, Madam Chair, sa rule naman natin, lahat dito tinatanong eh, no? So, according to the budget, whether it is in the past, kasi nakikita natin yung utilization noong mga budget, kahit na yung past years, ay pwede nating busisiin dito, Madam Chair. Tama ba ako, Madam Chair?
I will agree with you, Honorable Franz Castro. You may proceed,
yes,
Madam Vice President.
Yun yung sagot ko, ma'am. Nasaan ang topic natin dito at ang pinasubmit ninyo sa amin is the budget proposal of 2025. Where in the budget proposal of 2025 is the item confidential funds? Sa in aid of legislation nga ninyo, nakalagay nga doon sa rules ninyo, di ba? The discussion should be germane to the topic. The topic is a 2025 budget proposal. Now tell me,
Madam Vice President, the Honorable Franz Castro has already provided a sufficient explanation for why she asked the question. So please proceed with your answer.
Madam Chair,
it's a very
simple
question.
Why are we discussing the budget of 2023 and 2024? Madam Chair.
Yes, you may proceed.
I request that the chairperson of the Finance Committee preside over this hearing.
Madam Vice President, with due respect, you are not allowed to do that, Madam Vice President. You are not allowed to introduce any motion. You are a research person in this hearing, Madam Vice President.
I did not move, ma'am. I requested, as your resource person, I requested
so
that the chairperson of the committee.
Madam Vice President, just please answer the question. The issue on confidential funds falls squarely within our discussion of your 2025 budget.
Narinig mo yung sinabi niya, ma'am? Narinig
so
mo yung
please proceed.
Makikinig ka sa kanya kanina?
Absolutely.
Walang rules dito.
Please proceed and answer the question. It's a very simple question.
Diba?
Please explain the specific spending on those items that she enumerated, amounting to a total of, Honorable Franz, do you
amounting
want to repeat
to
that?
A total of 73.287 million. So, dahil may notice of disallowance, so ibig sabihin, Madam Chair, illegal ito, at not in accordance with the joint circular by the COA, DBM, and other related agencies. So kung ito ay dinisallow, so ibig sabihin, illegal yung paggamit nito. Madam Chair, nitong mga items na binanggit ko po, Madam Chair.
You cannot allow a member of the House to just claim that it is illegal. That is a notice of disallowance. That is a procedure inside the Commission on Audit. Hindi sa upuan niya.
Since ayaw magpaliwanag ang BP, so ibig sabihin nito, yung paggastos ng 125 million ay na pera ng taong bayan ay hindi maipaliwanag. So, yun lang, Madam Chair. Kaya hinihiling natin sa Vice President or OVP na kailangan na maipaliwanag itong mga sinasabing item dito. Anyway, Madam Chair, sa kanila naman ang galing, no, yung utilization at confidential and intelligence fund. And of course, ito lang naman ang hawak ko din dito, yung notice of disallowance. Kaya gusto talaga nating maintindihan, Madam Chair, kung ang notice of disallowance ay, so syempre, ipapaliwanag pa nila yan. Kung paano, di ba? So, kailangan malaman din ng taong bayan na sila yung nagbibigay ng pondo para sa operations ng OVP at lahat ng mga agency. At kailangan yung maipaliwanag. So, hindi pwede yung ganyan na, yung tactics na ganyan, na parang, parang sorry for the pusit, na kapag nasusukol na ang pusit, ay nag-aano ng maitim na tinta. So, ayaw natin ng ganun, Madam Chair. Kasi yung atin namang pinag-uusapan dito ay budget. No? So, wag naman mag-ugaling pusit ang Office of the Vice President.
In the beginning, It was settled that the issue would be the 2025 budget. And in all our hearings, to what I recall, when we want to question something about performance, we question the 2024 budget, not the 2023 budget. What is being questioned now is the 2023 budget, which was discussed very extensively last year. And that is the reason why the House removed the confidential funds. So that issue has already been, to my mind, for purposes of the budget hearing, laid to rest. So that's my observation, Madam Chair.
I think it's a reasonable ask. If there's a question, you may or may not answer. You're not compelled. But you just please say, I do not wish to answer. That's it. At least we know it's a direct response. And with that, we move to the next person on the list.
Madam Chair.
Hindi na po tayo matatapos.
Yan ang sinabi ko sa iyo kanina. Ayaw mo maniwala sa akin eh. Aabot talaga tayo ng bukas dito. Diba? Madam Chair.
Is this an inquiry regarding
what he said?
Yes, and
yes,
please,
ma'am.
I remind also our resource persons to please act in a respectful manner. Pasensya na po, hindi po kasama sa poder ninyo ang pagfa-fire ng presiding officer ng hearing na to. So yes, you may proceed.
So if you allow members of the House of Representatives lines like what you just said, like pusit, bakit mo ako kino-crucify for saying a fact that somebody is convicted of child abuse sitting in the chair? Pusit, and then I cannot fire the presiding chair. So bakit?
Yes, we...
Bakit napaka one-sided nito, ma'am?
Noted po.
Dahil ba madami kayo dyan sa kabila at nag-iisa ako dito?
We're not talking about the budget. We're accusing each other here. I'd like to find out from the resource speaker if this is the kind of hearing that we're going to have.
Sir, I am not the presiding officer of this hearing.
I know.
Yes, sir.
But the thing is, you're asking questions, Madam Chair. The resource speaker does not have any right to ask questions. Or do you have?
Where is that?
Madam Vice
in
President,
your rules that
Madam Vice
a resource person
this is
cannot
a budget hearing.
Request for
please
clarification.
Some order, please. Yes, Honorable Benny Abante, may proceed.
I'm just asking a question to our resource speaker, you know, because she's asking a question and she's accusing some of the members of this committee. I just would like to find out if we are the ones that have the right to ask questions, and her right is to answer the questions of the committee.
Okay, so we
got... po sa akin yung point of order, Madam Chair.
Yes.
I think you understand me, Madam Vice President, am I right?
No, sir, I'm going to ask the chair to ask you to clarify what are my accusations.
Yeah, please wait to be recognized, ma'am. Pasensya na po.
I'd like to discuss yung 10 million peso project na children's book. Madam Chair, dahil ayaw din po ng resource person ng question and answer, then ang paraan ko na lang po ay hindi patanong. Tell the committee sino po ang editor ng children's book na ito.
Madam Vice President.
Madam Chair, all the answers are... Oh, well, wala yan doon sa opening statement. I will forego the opportunity to defend the Office of the Vice President 2025 budget proposal by question and answer. And
Madam
I leave
Chair,
it to the House of Representatives to decide on the proposal
to tell this
as presented.
The name of the auditor of the children's book.
Yan ang nangyayari kapag
Honorable,
hindi
na
I didn't ask a question. I asked the resource person to tell the name, pero baka hindi pa nadidistinguish ano yung tanong, ano yung hindi. Pero since ayaw pong ibigay yung name ng editor ng children's book, ito kasi yung point natin, Madam Chair. The book contains many errors. Sige po, pakita po natin. Kasama po dyan, dahon ng banahaw. Wala naman pong dahon ng banahaw. Baka anahaw po yung tintukoy. Yung word na sila, dapat po sina. Tapos yung walang awa, dapat nga may hyphen po yan. Tapos, Madam Chair, nakalagay din yung pugad daw ng Quago ay nakapatong sa sanga. Madam Chair, sabi ng mga eksperto, ang owl's nest hindi po ay nakapatong sa sanga. Nasa either butas po yan ng mga puno or nasa ilalim ng lupa. Next, Madam Chair, this book is not child-friendly as per our writers kasi pag children's book, Madam Chair, hindi lang yung text yung mahalaga, pati yung visuals, Madam Chair. So, yung illustrations are not cohesive para yung elements pinatong lang sa background. Tapos, low value ito for illustrations kasi, Madam Chair, kahit nga yung pangalan ng illustrators ay maliit compared dun sa pangalan ng author. Well, in fact, for a children's book, magkasing bigat po ang papel ng illustrator tsaka ng author. Also, Madam Chair, sa content, nag-i-impose po siya na kung paano dapat umastang isang kaibigan. But, Madam Chair, for children's books, dapat hindi siya nag-i-impose ng anumang bagay sa bata. It should be fun. Masaya lang dapat yung bata na binabasa yung libro. So, Madam Chair, this book na pinopropose, na pondohan, and actually, ang topic na nga natin, 2025 budget, gusto ng resource person, we limit to the 2025 budget, pero hindi pa rin sinasagot. But this book, Madam Chair, will just contribute to the worsening of the learning crisis. Hindi po siya actually ay makabata. Ano? Kaya, Madam Chair, before I end sa second round, kasi kanina meron din pong ad hominem sa atin, meron pang disinformation about this representation. Madam Chair, kung okay lang naman yung mga libro at halimbawa, kung totoo pa kayong sinasabi about me, I would even suggest sa OVP, dagdagan yung budget, baka makalimang libro pa ang Vice Presidente. Pwede pa nga may special edition tungkol sa kwento ng buhay ko. Pero given, Madam Chair, na hindi din talaga pumapasa sa standards ng pagsusulat ng libro. And I also think, Madam Chair, na throughout this hearing, hindi successfully na-defend yung budget ng Office of the Vice President. So ako, personally, I'm inclined na hindi natin i-terminate yung budget briefing for the Office of the Vice President. So yun na lang muna, Madam Chair. Maraming salamat.
Madam Chair.
Yes, Madam Vice President.
Yes. Ma'am, the name of the editor of the book is Raul Manuel. It's a joke, ma'am. You strike it out of the record if you want.
Hindi na rin ako magtatanong kasi alam ko, paulit-ulit din yung kanyang isasagot. So, nakaka-frustrate lang dahil ito ay pera ng taong bayan. I would like to thank the Vice President for showing her true colors to the House and her lack of respect for check and balances and the separation of powers and accountability. We are a republic. We don't have a king or a queen. Now, Madam Chair, dahil hindi naman masagot ni VP Sara yung mga katanungan ng miyembro, may I move now to defer the hearing of the budget of the Office of the Vice President. I so move, Madam Chair.
Is there any objection? Hearing none, same is approved. So the hearing or the briefing, the budget briefing, shall be rescheduled or shall continue on September 10 at 9 a.m.